Sicily is represented by a woman's head with three legs because each one of its sides has been inseminated.
ある日アーチとガルディアのことについて気づいて怒り狂ってしまいます。そしてアーチを捕まえて殺そうと決心します。まず巨人はガルディアを奪い去り、アーチをこの海へ投げ入れたのです。
I am happy to think that I now carry in my soul a picture of Sicily, that unique and beautiful island, which is clear, authentic, and complete. Now there is nothing else I want to see in the south. A word about Homer. His descriptions, his similes, etc., which to us seem merely poetic, are in fact utterly natural, though drawn, of course, with an inner comprehension which takes one's breath away. Even the events he narrates are fabulous and fictitious. They have a naturalness about them, which I have never felt so strongly as in the presence of the settings he describes.
アーチを海に投げ入れて死んだことを確実にするために、エトナの山からどんどんと岩を投げ入れるのです。アーチはとうとう死んでしまいました。そういったわけで、ここの海にはたくさんの岩がゴツゴツと見られるわけです。これがエトナ、違う、アーチとガルディアの物語です。
Say briefly what I think about the ancient writers and us moderns. They represented things and persons as they are in themselves. We usually represent only their subjective effect. They depicted the horror, we depict horribly. They depicted the pleasing, we pleasantly, and so on. Now that my mind is stored with images of all these coasts and promontories, gulfs and bays, islands and headlands, rocky cliffs and sandy beaches, wooden hills and gentle pastures, fertile fields, flower gardens, tended trees, festooned vines, mountains wreathed in clouds, eternally serene plains, and the all-encircling ever-changing colors and moods. For the first time, the Odyssey has become a living truth to me. This climate offers the best possible conditions for making observations. And now I am very close to the secret of the reproduction and organization of plants, and that it is the simplest thing imaginable. To the main question, where the germ is hidden, I'm quite certain I have found the answer. The Urpflanz, the primal plant, is going going to be the strangest creature in the world, which nature itself shall envy me. With this model and the key to it, it will be possible to go on forever inventing plants and know that their existence is logical. That is to say, if they do not actually exist, they could, for they are not the shadowy phantoms of a vain imagination, but possess an inner necessity and truth. Then the same law will be applicable to all other living organisms.